Brooks, this is really my favorite thing to do in the classroom, and it's so wonderful that I can teach it to such an astute and qualified teacher assistant. And it might be a trip down memory lane, it might not be, but nevertheless, mm-hmm. You're here to learn it. Okay. Well, I'm going to write this number here. What is that?
9.
It's a 9. You remember the beads there, right? Mm-hmm. Can you get a 9? Ah, wonderful. You got a 9 right there. All right. What if I did this? Watch what I'm going to do. It's going to be, it might be tricky. What is that?
9.
Yeah. Couldn't trick you there, right? What did I do?
You put 5 and 4.
That's right. Because 5 plus 4 equals 9. When I have one single bar out here, and I write 9, I'm going to call this a monomial. Okay? But, even though it's the same value, even though this is the same as 9, we're going to write it in an algebraic form. This is 5 plus 4. And we call this kind of term a binomial. Okay? So, 9 is a monomial. 5 plus 4, even though it's the same thing, is a...
It's a...
Binomial.
Yeah, binomial.
Binomial. Okay. Keep that in mind. Okay. I'm going to skip to a really interesting part here. What I have here is what?
It's
100 square.
Yeah.
What do we have here?
100 square.
100 square. I'm going to take my rubber bands. I'm going to do something cool. I'm going to divide this up into parts. This amount here and this here. I'm going to do the same thing on this side. Look at that. A complete side is how long?
Oh, 10.
10. But we divided this up a little bit, though, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
How much is in this sector here?
7.
7, and this is?
3.
3. Take a look at this side. We have another 10 altogether, right? How many is here?
3.
3. How many is here?
7.
7. Take a look at this here. How many in this part?
3.
3.
7.
7. Over here, you have
7.
7 and 3.